A wise man has said, الرحمه لا تشترى ولا تباع ولا تلقن بل هي مستقره في اعماق القلوب النقيه. That the nature of mercy is not bought, taught, nor is a soul, but is found in the depth of pure hearts. From amongst all the mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one great mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and I today is Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. That O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have certainly granted you the seven often repeated verses and this great Qur'an. The seven often repeated verses refers to Surah Al-Fatiha. Now I would like to mention a few lessons in regards to the etiquette of the dua that we can learn from Surah Al-Fatiha. Number one, from the first part of Surah Al-Fatiha, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm Al-Din. The Mufassirun have extracted the lesson that whenever a person makes dua, he should praise and glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, from the second part of Surah Al-Fatiha, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, we learn the right of dua. That when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we only attribute success to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to oneself. Third, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ آمين. From the last part of Surah Al-Fatiha, we learn that even though we may be praying our salah, paying our zakah, fasting and so on, we should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the correct guidance. So from this Ramadan onwards, let's strive and make our du'as in the best of forms. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who understand the reality of du'a. Ameen. Jazakumullahu khayra. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.